We'd like to thank you, my friends, for tuning into the radio program. And we'd like to thank all of our internet radio listeners. We'd like to thank our friend, Mr. Minuteman, for all of your gracious comments. And we appreciate you so very, very, very much. We thank you for supporting the radio program in your area. And we're giving God the praise and the glory and the honor for you. We thank you. I thank you. And we appreciate you, Mr. Minuteman, for all of your encouragement, for all of your encouraging words. My friends, if you have your Bibles with you this morning, please turn with me to the Word of the Lord found in the book of Matthew, chapter 17, and beginning at verse number 11. That's Matthew, chapter 17, and beginning at verse number 11. And Jesus answered and said unto them, Elias truly shall come first and restore all things. But I say unto you that Elias is come already, and they knew him not, but have done unto him whatsoever they have listed. Likewise shall also the Son of Man suffer of them. Let's go down, my friends, to verse number 14. And when they were come to the multitudes, there came to him a certain man kneeling down to him, saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is a lunatic and sore vexed, for oftentimes he is falling into the fire and off into the water, and I brought him to thy disciples, and they could not cure him. I'd like to talk to you today, my friends, for a few minutes here. God has a plan for your life, and look out for your future. God has a plan for your life, and look out for your future. My friend, this father had a child. He had a son, and the son had been possessed by the devil. And the enemy was destroying his life and causing his life to diminish and not allowing him to be able to succeed in this life. We know that we had children to graduate from schools on this year. Amen. And we thank God for their achievement. But this father specifically had a son that was unable to do the things that he wanted to do. And my friend, the Bible says that he came and he saw the man by the name of Jesus. First of all, let me back up a few minutes. He came and he brought his son to the disciples of Jesus, and hoping that his disciples would be able to cure him of his problem. But they were unable to cure the child of the specific problem that he had. The child, God had a plan for the life of the child, and he had a future for this child. Your future, my friend, is based on your life, and what you are going to do with your future is up to you. See, God does not want you to be out of the will of God. He wants you to be able to achieve in this life. He does not want you to be a drunkard. He does not want you to be addicted to any substance of any kind. He wants you to be able to have a life free, to be able to stand on the Word of God. See, the Bible says, and Jesus answered and said unto them, Elias truly shall come first and restore all things. My friend, this child needed to have been restored by the hand of God. So, see, sometimes you just need a touch from the hand of Almighty God. You need a touch from the Master, my friend. A supernatural encounter with the power of Almighty God. See, it may not come through a specific individual. It may not come through that individual who you think is going to come through. Jesus had to step in to the situation and into the matter at hand itself and begin to show them exactly and specifically and give them the instructions that was needed to be able to set free this young man. I don't know about you, my friend, but if you have ever seen somebody oppressed and depressed, and beat down by the devil, it's not a pretty sight. It's not a beautiful sight. And my friend, can you imagine if that was your family member? Can you imagine if that was somebody that you loved? Can you imagine if that was somebody that was close to your heart? Can you imagine, my friend, this father and how he felt about his child? So he did the thing that he was going to do, how he brought his child to Jesus. And said, Jesus, my son, he came down. He came humbly to God. He came kneeling down. See, the Bible says, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. He recognized that Jesus was Lord. And he began to realize and said, Lord, I need you to help my child. You see, my friend, there is still yet help for your child. Hallelujah, there's help. Glory be to God. For that young man, that young woman, there's help, hallelujah, in Jesus' mighty name. But we've got to begin to take them to the man by the name of Jesus. Take them, glory be to God, to somebody that has the power of the Lord embedded within their life and not afraid of the devil. And understand and realize that the power of God is able to deliver and set the captives completely free. Do you really want to see your child delivered? Do you really want to see your daughter set free? My friend, then bring them to the throne room of God. Bring them, hallelujah, to the hand of Almighty God. And God will deliver your child. Look here at the word of God, my friend. The Bible says, but I say unto you that Elias is truly already come, and they knew him not, but they have done unto them whatsoever they have listed. And likewise, the Son of Man, he shall suffer. That means he's going to be scandalized. That means that they're not going to believe in him. You see, my friend, when you don't believe in the power of God, when you think that God is just a myth, and you think that God does not exist, then the enemy has begun to get into your mind and cause you to step out of the will of the Lord. And God is unable to do anything for you. My friend, but when you begin to believe and say, Lord, I am a believer. I believe in the power of God. I believe, Lord, you are able to help me. I believe, God, that you are able to deliver me. My friend, you see, I remember years ago, they had some children, and they had dealt with some Ouija boards, and they thought that the devil was just a play devil. They thought that the devil was just a fake, but the devil infiltrated and got into the mind of the young, and they began to do wicked things, my friend, and they had to be delivered by the power of the Lord. And the demons that ran into their lives had caused them to do devilish things. My friend, I do not want to see any young child, how do you be possessed by the devil? You see, the Bible says that this demon has threw the child into the fire, and he drug the child into the water, trying to kill the child. But Jesus spoke to the devil and told the devil to get out in the name of Jesus. And by the power of the Lord, you can be delivered and set free within your life. It doesn't really make a difference what the devil has tried to put on your life. Hallelujah. But you can be set free today in Jesus' mighty name. Do you really want to see your child delivered? Do you really want to see your child to be set free, my friend? Then call on the name of Jesus. Where there is power and authority, there's authority, my friend, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, and when they came to Jesus, the multitude, hallelujah, when the multitude came to Jesus, my friend, they realized that he had all power in his hand. Jesus got all power in his hand. He's got power to deliver your child so that your child can have a future. He has power, my friend, to set the captives free. I don't care what you've been under. I don't care what you've been in. I don't care what the devil has, hallelujah, surrounded your life with. You can be delivered. You can be delivered. You can be delivered by the power of Almighty God. Yes, there is deliverance for you. Yes, you can be set free. Yes, you can walk in the newness, in the power of the Lord. But my friend, you got to come to Jesus while the blood is still running warm in your vein. You got to make up in your mind today. Hallelujah, I've got a plan. God got a plan for your life. And it's not the plan of destruction. No, my friend, the devil has destruction planned for your life. But Jesus got blessings ready for your life. He's got blessings in store for your life, my friend. Why don't you make up in your mind today? I'm coming to Jesus. Hallelujah. No doubt in my mind, my friend. You're going to lose some people along the way, but I'm still coming to Jesus. I'm dragging, but I'm coming. My mind is gone, but I'm coming. I don't have no friends, but I'm coming. I've lost some faith in God, but I'm coming. I'm coming to Jesus because that's where my help is going to come from. All of my help that I need is going to come from the hand of Almighty God. My friend, make up in your mind today that you're going to come to Jesus. Glory be to God, so that you can have a bright future, so that you can have a life, my friend, that is fulfilling. Glory be to God, a blessed life, my friend. Do you really want a blessed life? Then you got to make up in your mind today, I'm coming to the Lord. I've made my decision that I'm coming to Jesus while the blood is still yet running warm in my vein. The Bible said, the Father said, Lord, have mercy on my son. Glory be to God. Lord Jesus, have mercy on the young today. Have mercy on their mind, Jesus. Give them a mind, God, that stayed on you, Lord Jesus. Touch them by your spirit. There are still yet young people that need to know who Jesus really is. And I believe that there are young people out there that are filled with the power of God. And they are saved, my friend. They are saved this day. Glory be to God. But my friend, there are still yet some that do not believe in the power of God. There's still yet some, my friend, that the enemy is trying to destroy their lives. Glory be to God. But my friend, you can be delivered and you can be set free by the power of God. Make up in your mind today that you're coming. You're coming. And I can see them coming. I can feel them coming. I can see them coming to Jesus. I can see them surrendering their lives. Hallelujah to God. Surrender your life to God today. Lord, have mercy. Glory be to God. In Jesus' mighty name. My friend, come on to Jesus. Come on, come on, come on. Come on to Jesus. While the blood is running warm in your vein, make up your mind today. Make up your mind today so that your future will be bright. Glory be to God. God got a plan in store for your life. Until next time, may God bless you and heaven smile upon you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.